In this video, I'm going to show you a technique to help you quickly match color in images using Photoshop. In this example, I have two couches. I want the lighter color couch to be the same as the color of the couch above it. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select the couch on the bottom here, and I'm going to use the object selection tool and make my selection. I'm going to use my quick selection tool to take the selection away from the legs here. That's all I need to do. And now that I have my couch selected, I'm going to load that selection onto its own layer by hitting Control or Command J. Throughout this example, I'm going to keep layer one selected. I'm only going to work on layer one. To help make this adjustment easier, I'm going to make a color swatch. I'm going to use the rectangular marquee tool, and I'm going to make a small rectangle, which is going to serve as my swatch from the couch that I want to change the color of. Now I'm going to put the swatch on the couch that has my target color. So I'm going to hold down, for Mac, it's Command plus Option. For Windows, it's Control plus Alt. I'm on a Mac, so I'm going to hold down Command plus Option at the same time and click and drag. And I'm going to put this swatch up here on the couch that has my target color. I'll deselect that with Command D. This swatch is on the same layer as the couch that I made a selection of. So now if we change the swatch color, the color of the other couch will change because we are on the same layer. So we're going to change the color using channels. I'm going to go into my channels panel. If I go to each channel, I'm going to be able to see the swatch. Here's a red channel, here's a green channel, here's a blue channel. So we're going to start with the red channel, and I'm going to come up to Image, Adjustments, and Curves. So we're going to use a combination of curves and channels to change the color of our couch. So on the red channel, I'm going to pull this down, and you can see the swatch starting to change. It's starting to blend in. Just bring this down until you get it to blend in as best as possible. If there's a difference in textures, it may be a little bit more difficult to blend this in, but do the best you can. Look away and look back after a minute or so. Just so your eyes get used to seeing the way it's blending in, and choose something that you think is blending in pretty good, and then say okay. Go to the green channel, do the same thing. Come up here to Image, Adjustments, Curves. Now in the green channel, bring this down until blends in to your liking, or it's pretty close. You'll probably still be able to see the swatch a little bit. That's okay. We'll go to the blue channel, Image, Adjustments, Curves, and now we'll adjust the level here on the blues. And this one is blending in a little bit more, a little bit better, and say okay. And then we'll turn on the RGB, go back over to our layers panel. Now we can use the eraser tool to get rid of the swatch. We don't need that anymore. You can see it did a pretty good job. It left any highlights that were already in the leather. If you want, you can come down here to your layers panel and add a levels adjustment. Click right here to clip the adjustment layer to the layer below. And you can use your levels to lighten up your color a little bit, especially if you're trying to match this, if it were right next to each other in the same room. But slight adjustments would help like that. Now, if you want, you can add highlights. Come down to the bottom of your layers panel, add a new layer. With that new layer selected, hold Alt, and you see the arrow has changed. You clip that to the layer below with a soft round brush, paint with white with a flow of around 30. Follow the areas where there's already a highlight. Just brush in the areas where you see a highlight already there. Kind of just follow the way it is, and then change your blend mode to soft light and lower your opacity. And there's before and there's the after, just a subtle enhancement of your highlights. And here's the before, and here's the after. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.